The Empress Xiaoquancheng, originally was from the plain red banner. She was the third empress of the Emperor Daoguang and the biological mother of the Emperor Xianfeng. When she became the empress, Daoguang moved her branch to the bordered yellow banner. Niuhulushi was 26 years younger than the Emperor Daoguang and was Daoguang's true love. Niuhulushi came into the imperial palace through the Eight Banners imperial election. In the election, Daoguang fell in love with her at first sight. So, Daoguang gave Niuhulushi a title, Quan Pin, the noble lady Quan. Quan means perfect. At this year, Niuhulushi was only 14 years old. 3 months later, the noble lady Quan was promoted to the consort Quan. In the summer of 1824, the consort Quan was pregnant. Later, she was promoted to the noble consort Quan. Because at that time, Daoguang's empress was still alive, so the noble consort Quan was the extra highest rank consort. In 1833, the empress passed away. Daoguang promoted the noble consort Quan to the managing inner court imperial noble consort. In whole Qing dynasty, only Qianlong's step empress and the empress Xiaoquancheng once got this special imperial noble consort title. In 1834, the imperial noble consort Quan officially became the empress when she was 26 years old. Xiaoquancheng totally gave birth to 2 girls and 1 boy. Her first kid was Daoguang's third daughter, who died at 11 years old. Daoguang posthumously promoted the little princess to the Princess Duanshun of the first rank. Xiaoquancheng's second daughter, the Princess Shou An of the first rank, was Daoguang's favorite daughter. Xiaoquancheng's son inherited Daoguang's throne, who was known as the Emperor Xianfeng. In Daoguang's heart, Xianfeng wasn't a qualified crown prince, but Daoguang loved her mother so much, so eventually he chose Xianfeng as his heir. Xianfeng had a famous consort, the Empress Dowager Cixi, who accelerated the Qing dynasty's finish. Although Daoguang truly loved Xiaoquancheng, but I don't think Daoguang's other imperial women liked her. The main reason was Daoguang spent too many time with Xiaoquancheng and ignored other imperial women. In Qing dynasty, when the emperor spent too many time with one woman, the empress should appreciate the emperor, stop, and visit other women. Apparently, Xiaoquancheng didn't do it. Even worse, after Daoguang visited other women, Xiaoquancheng always found some excuse to punish those women. In Qing dynasty, this behavior was considered as unethical. In 1833, the Empress Xiaoquancheng passed away at 33. Daoguang felt desperate and never promoted an empress. In official documents, the records about Xiaoquancheng's death was really simple. The document only recorded Xiaoquancheng's death time and her age when she was passed away. There wasn't records about the cause of death. So, Xiaoquancheng was the only empress in Qing dynasty whose death was a mystery. Thank you for watching this video. See you soon.